Allwyn de Silva and Reverend Monsignor Barthol Barretto, a program called Down Memory Lane.
I was born in a very traditional family and also a traditional parish, St. Blaise's Church, Amboli, Andheri. My family did have an influence on my life. We used to say the rosary, say the morning prayer, and then go for mass every morning. My two brothers joined the seminary and two sisters joined the religious life. So every second Sunday and third Sunday, I would visit my brothers and sisters. But I think what made an impact in my life, a certain passage or a certain line, the voice of the people is the voice of God. And therefore, the greatest impact on my life has been the voice of the people. I used to listen to people in the slums. I used to listen to people who were suffering. I used to listen to people who are marginalized and on the edges of society. And that made a tremendous impact on me, to work for justice and for the rights of people. Of course, my brother, Father Raymond de Silva, played a very important part because he was a pioneer in social justice in the Archdiocese of Bombay. So I was ordained by Cardinal Valerian Gracias in 1975. I was an assistant for 2 years in St. Anthony's Church, Vakola. But then the bishop asked me whether I could look after the vocation center. Of course, I continued being an assistant for 8 years. So I was in charge of the vocation center for 6 years. Then they felt that I should go to the National Vocation Service Center. After my term got over, 3-year term, I asked Cardinal Simon Pimenta whether he could place me in St. Jude's Church, Jerry Mary. At that time it was full of slums. And that was a wonderful experience because I started the small human communities and it grew, Hindus, Muslims, Christians. We all formed a community and there was complete harmony. I remember during the 1992 riots, there was no riot in Jerry Mary. After 8 years in Jerry Mary, Cardinal Simon Pimenta said, would you like to teach in the seminary? For 6 years, I taught in the seminary, but I also asked him whether I could have some pastoral work. So he made me the parish priest of St. Jude's, Malad East. After completing 6 years, Cardinal Ivan asked me whether I could look after Dharavi, since I had a lot of experience in the slums. So for 7 years, I spent my life in St. Anthony's Church, Dharavi. And I also built the church. And then later on, I went to Our Lady of Nazareth Church, Binder. It was a very wonderful experience because at that time, the whole of the Dharavi Island was facing the small economic problem. And as a dean, I felt I was with the people struggling to cancel that SEZ. Later on, I came to St. John the Baptist Church, Thane. I've completed now 6 years. And I felt that the people were really good. They were united. They helped us to restore the church. And you can see that St. John the Baptist Church is one of the heritage churches. I've held many assignments in the diocese. I've been dean, I've been episcopal vicar. As I said, I have been also in charge of the Justice and Peace Commission, then the Office of Environment, the Prison Ministry, and also the Employment Committee and the Conciliation Committee. All these assignments have given me a lot of experience, how the church functions in Mumbai, how to deal with various issues, especially with conflicts. I've taken as my motto as a bishop, the care for creation. Because I feel that this is a very important issue. It has been emphasized by Pope Francis. He has written the encyclical Laudato Si. This care for creation is not only about the universe, it is about people also. Because people are the causes of climate change. and climate change affects the people, especially the poor. So my motto of care for creation includes the universe, it includes the world, as well as the poor and the marginalized. During my priesthood, I am thankful to a group of friends, especially priest friends. We used to meet often and we used to reflect on the church, on the archdiocese, and this reflection helped me in broadening my vision. I also have a lot of friends, men and women, in the various parishes. And they also have been an inspiration to me. And lastly, I feel, as I said before, the voice of the people is the voice of God. I have done a lot of exposure immersion programs in India, in the Philippines, and in various places. And I saw the sufferings of the people, and they have formed me. During my retreat, I was struck by John 17, where Jesus said, I've taken care of them. You know, I can go back to my Father. I suppose in the few years that I are left to be an active bishop, I wish I could say the same thing, that I have taken care of my flock. I have taken care of my people. Hopefully, I can say at the end that I've seen that they are one.
This, I'm the youngest of them all. I come from a deeply religious family background. We are five brothers. I'm the youngest of them all. I owe my vocation to my grandparents, because my grandparents made it a point to pray the rosary every day, to see that we go for Sunday Mass. And when I was in the early secondary section,
we welcome His Eminence Cardinal Oswald, Gracious, and the two bishops-elect, Reverend Monsignor Barthol, Barretto, and Reverend Monsignor Allwyn de Silva.
I decided to join the altar service. I once again vividly remember how at the end of a particular mass, the late Father Cosme Rego of Belgaum Diocese caught me in the sacristy and he says, Barthol, I heard the Lord whisper to me that you are going to join the seminary. And those were the days when the Lord would constantly speak to me, follow me. Particularly at the consecration time. At the end of the 10th standard, one of the sisters of Canossa Convent asked me, what do you want to do? So I plucked up courage and I said, I want to be a priest. The late Bishop Ferdinand Fonseca, he was the rector, he told me, he says that I was too small to join the seminary. He said, you go to college and if you want, join the quest program. That made my vocation grow. And from there on, I made a decision to join the seminary in the early 80s. Seminary was fantastic. We did everything, studies, games, entertainment. And it was Bishop Agnello who presented us for ordination on the 8th of April, 1989. At the hands of the late Simon Cardinal Pimenta, I was ordained priest. St. Francis Xavier Church, Dabul. That was my first appointment. What gave me the satisfaction and the joy was the pastoral visitation. From there on, I moved into the Diocesan Pastoral Center, Bandra. When I was director of the Youth Center, one of the new initiatives that we had undertaken was Youth South, a festival of youth for the youth of the Archdiocese of Bombay. Imagine those years, 2,000, 3,000 youth attending for a one-day festival, going back home, charged as ever, to minister to the needs of the youth. Having completed my ministry, I was appointed to St. Francis Xavier Church, Panvel. That for me was a challenge because I had to build a church, and to build a church was no easy task. 3 years, and Cardinal Ivan requested me to go to Wagley State. That was the first time when I was made parish priest. It was a fruitful experience. From the pastoral ministry into an institution at Archbishop's House was quite a challenge because Cardinal Ivan Dias requested me to come to Bishop's House to be his secretary. But it was only 1.5 years to work under Cardinal Ivan Dias. From there on, it was my joy and honor to work with Cardinal Oswald Gracias. From the Archbishop's House, I was told to go to St. Thomas Church, Goregaon. In the initial years of my ministry there, I was supposed to convene and organize the Silver Jubilee of the small Christian communities first started in Bombay 25 years ago at St. Thomas Corrigan. At the end of my third year, Cardinal Oswald Gracious called me to Bishop's House. And I thought as Dean, he had invited me to brief him about the deanery. And slowly, he sneaked in my transfer news from a small church. I was now told to take over one of the biggest churches in our Archdiocese. I see Church Borivali, Our Lady of Immaculate Conception Church, has made me the person I am today, giving me that pastoral fulfillment. 27 years as a priest, and here I am enjoying every bit of my pastoral ministry. Basically, I shared a good rapport with my brother priests. Whether I was the director of the Diocesan Youth Center, or secretary of the Archbishop, or as dean, I've always made it a point to visit my priests, be they sick or otherwise. I also enjoy a very, very good relationship with my parishioners. I have made it a point to visit my people on a systematic basis and also visit the sick and the suffering at home and in the hospitals. Many of them have told me that my visits to them have brought joy into their lives. Not only they, but I can also say with sincerity, it has brought fulfillment in my life as a priest. As a priest over the past 27 years in my ministry, I have, with God's graces, undertaken a number of initiatives in the Archdiocese. In the year 2014, in the month of November, Cardinal Oswald Gracious invited me to organize a rally for the extraordinary ministers of Holy Communion. And that brought tremendous joy into my life, because for the first time in our Archdiocese, a rally of the Eucharistic ministers was held. One of the initiatives undertaken in the extraordinary Jubilee Year of Mercy was the Mercy in Action, where we motivated our people to sacrifice, and any sacrifice that they made, be it a child or a youth or an adult, or even a senior citizen, all that they had to do was symbolically put a 1 rupee coin into the Mercy in Action box. And we collected a huge amount of money, and the entire money was given to the Diocese of Amravati for the farmers in distress. One of the characteristic features of Jesus' ministry that has inspired me tremendously is when Jesus washed the feet of his apostles. This new commandment of love that he taught us was what inspired me to take as my motto, love in action. As a priest, I made it a point to walk the Jesus way, to love everybody. I have failed at times, but every night is a time of consciousness, asking myself, have I loved my people? Have I loved my work? Have I loved the Jesus way? I come from a deeply religious family background.
As you prepare to participate in this solemn service of the Episcopal consecration, we trust that you will respect the sanctity of this place by ensuring that your mobile phone will not disturb the sacred proceedings. You are also requested to refrain from clicking photographs either by camera or mobile during the service. Professionally clicked photographs and videos can be viewed on the Archdiocese website and Facebook page. Those wishing to purchase the video presentation of the service may contact the Catholic Communications Center. Please use the hymn sheets for participation in the service. Good evening, my dear friends. In the Catholic Church, a bishop is an ordained minister and always a man who holds the fullness of the sacrament of holy orders and is responsible for teaching doctrine, governing Catholics in his jurisdiction, and sanctifying the world, and for representing the Church. Catholics trace the origin of the office of bishop to the apostles, who were endowed with a special charism by the Holy Spirit at Pentecost. Catholics believe this special charism has been transmitted through an unbroken succession of bishops by the laying on of hands in the sacrament of holy orders. An auxiliary bishop is a full-time assistant to a diocesan bishop. Auxiliaries assist the diocesan bishop in a variety of ways and are usually appointed as vicars general or episcopal vicars of the diocese in which they serve. Today, the Archdiocese of Bombay will be blessed with two new auxiliary bishops as Reverend Monsignor Allwyn de Silva and Reverend Monsignor Barthol Barretto will be consecrated at the hands of His Eminence Oswald Cardinal Gracias as Principal Consecrator, and His Grace Archbishop Vincent Concesao, Archbishop Emeritus of Delhi, and His Lordship Emeritus Bishop Bosco Pena as co-consecrators. We now stand and join the choir in singing the entrance hymn number 1 in the hymn sheets as we rejoice in God's house today for His numerous blessings on us. Thank you.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God our Father, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. A very hearty welcome to each one of you, my sisters and brothers who have come from all over the Archdiocese and even beyond for this ordination, Episcopal Ordination service. I want to, in a special way, welcome our bishops who have come. We've got bishops from as far as away as Kashmir and Sri Lanka. Thank you, Bishop Ivan. We've got Bishop Elias from Aurangabad, Bishop Lutz Daniel, Amravati, Aurangabad, Bishop Thomas, thank you for coming. Bishop Ignatius Menezes, good friend from Ajmer, from Slovenia, from Nagpur, Archbishop Abraham, Archbishop of Goa, Patriarch, from Vasai, Archbishop Felix, and the rest are from Bombay, our own family. Archbishop is also from the co-consecrator. Arch Vincent Concessão is the Emeritus Archbishop of Delhi. And I want to welcome from the Nunciature. The Nuncio is not yet in India. And so on behalf of him, we have the Chargé d'Affaires and First Counselor. Thank you very much, Monsignor Henrik and Tuomo, for having come. It's a joy to have you over here. And to each one of you. But I must say my heartiest welcome is to Barthol. We'll call him Barthol for the last time before he's Bishop Barthol. And same way, Allwyn, before we call him Bishop Allwyn. And of course, to his dearest, his mother over here, and the brothers and sisters of Allwyn, hearty welcome. During this Eucharistic sacrifice, we pray specially for them, for the coming of the Holy Spirit on them, that they might give effective leadership to the Archdiocese of Bombay, in the team together, helping the church in India, the church in the Western region, and the Universal Church to spread God's kingdom, to make the gospel present and operative all over the world. Let's begin the sacrifice now, putting ourselves in God's presence and asking His forgiveness for our sins. As we humbly say, I confess. In my thoughts and in my words, what I have done, what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary Virgin, the angels and saints. May Almighty God have mercy on us, may He forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life. Let's all together now praise God in the words of the Gloria. Gloria in excelsis Deo. Eternal Shepherd, who governing your flock with watchful care, choose to raise these priests, your servants, to the ministry of the high priesthood this day. Grant that they may carry out worthily the office of bishops, and grant by their holiness of life, they may everywhere prove to be true witnesses to Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Let me sit.
A reading from the book of Isaiah. The Spirit of the Lord God is upon me, because the Lord has anointed me to bring good tidings to the afflicted. He has sent me to bind up the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives, and the opening of the prison to those who are bound, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor and the day of vengeance of our God, to comfort all who mourn, to grant to those who mourn in Zion, to give them a garland instead of ashes, the oil of gladness instead of mourning, the mantle of praise instead of a faint spirit. But you shall be called the priests of the Lord. Men shall speak of you as the ministers of our God. I will faithfully give them their recompense, and I will make an everlasting covenant with them. Their descendants shall be known among the nations, and their offspring in the midst of the peoples. All who see them shall acknowledge them, that they are a people whom the Lord has blessed. This is the word of the Lord.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Consider your call, brethren. Not many of you were wise according to the flesh. Not many were powerful. Not many were of noble birth. But God chose what is foolish in the world to shame the wise. God chose what is weak in the world to shame the strong. God chose what is low and despised in this world, even things that are not, to bring to nothing things that are, so that no flesh might boast in the presence of God. He is the source of your life in Christ Jesus, whom God made our wisdom, our righteousness, and sanctification, and redemption. Therefore, as it is written, let him who boasts, boast of the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Gospel according to St. John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When Jesus had showed himself to his disciples and had eaten with them, he said to Simon Peter, Simon, son of John, do you love me more than these do? He answered, yes, Lord, you know I love you. Jesus said to him, feed my lambs. A second time Jesus said to him, Simon, son of John, do you love me? He replied, yes, Lord, you know I love you. Jesus said to him, look after my sheep. Then he said to him a third time, Simon, son of John, do you love me? Peter was upset that he asked him the third time, do you love me? And he said, Lord, you know everything. You know I love you. Jesus said to him, feed my sheep. The Gospel of the Lord.
Friends, we now begin with the sacred and meaningful rite of the Episcopal ordination ceremony. Let us pray that God's Spirit may strengthen and inspire our bishops-elect, Monsignor Allwyn de Silva and Monsignor Barthol Barretto, as we all stand and join the choir in singing a hymn invoking the Holy Spirit.
O Spirit, source of wisdom, fount of grace and life, inflame our hearts, we ask you, with the fire of love, grant us a deeper vision of your truth divine, and every saving virtue in our hearts enshrine.
The bishops-elect are now presented for ordination. Bishop-elect Monsignor Allwyn de Silva is assisted by Father Percy de Silva, his brother, and Father John de Mello, his close friend. While Bishop-elect Monsignor Barthol Barretto is assisted by Father Elias de Souza, his classmate, and Father John Barretto, his close friend. The apostolic letter announcing their appointment as bishops will be read first in Latin by Monsignors Henrik and Monsignor Tuomo, our distinguished representatives from the Vatican Embassy, and then in English, followed by the consent from the people of God, as we will all join the choir in singing the acclamation, "Thanks be to God." The congregation may be seated.
Most Reverend Father, the Holy Catholic Church, our mother, asks you to ordain this priest, Allwyn Blaise de Silva, to the responsibility of the episcopate.
Have you amended from the Holy See?
We have.
Then let it be read.
Franciscus Episcopus Servus Servorum Dei, Dilecto Filio Allwyn Silva, a clero Archidiocesis Bombayensis, ibique jactenus Vicario Episcopali, et Curioni Paretie Sancti Ioannis Baptiste, electo eiusdem archidiocesis auxiliari simulque titulo durensi exornato, salutem et apostolicam benedictionem. In bono sinu misericordiae Dominice requiescentes, quae amorem suum creaturis omnibus ubique ac perennite manifestat pro solicitudine nostra pastorari Christi fidelium gregis cure providemus et sacris ecclesiae ministris pro ovium salute laborantibus omnia concedimus perque eorum ministerium ad animarum salutem et spiritualem fidelium consolationem uberiore cum fructu valeant ad implere. Animum nostrum ergo ad necessitates communitatis bombayensis libenter convertimus, cuius sacrorum antistes venerabilis frater noster Osvaldus sacre romana ecclesiae cardinalis gratias nuperime petivit. Ut novi, quidem socii vite diocesane moderande, frui posset iuvamine. Qua, per moti, solicitudine de te, dilecte fili, cogitavimus, quem virtudibus humanis ornatum, ceterisque dotibus preditum arbitramur, quae te aptum efficiunt ad munia episcoparia in ecclesia explenda. Proinde, audito consilio congregationis pro gentium evangelizatione apostolice nostre auctoritatis plenitudine, charum literarum virtute te episcopum auxiliarem in ecclesia metropolitana bombayensi constituimus adito titulo durensi ac debitis concessis iuribus congruisque impositis obligationibus quae huic officio nectuntur. Ordinationem episcopalem ubi vis extra urbem servatis liturgicis normis a quolibet catholico episcopo suscipere poteris datis prius fidei professione et iure iurando fidelitatis erga nos successorosque nostros ad ecclesiastice legis normas. Dominum, dilecte fini, pie deprecambo, ut prestet te iugiter recordari humilitatis ilius maxime excolende, quae nos justis equat ac diligere facit quos Iesus dilexit et docere quae docuit. Datum Rome apud Sanctum Petrum, die vicesimo mensis decembris, anno Domini bismelesimo decimo sexto, pontificatus nostri quarto, Franciscus.
Francis Bishop, servant of the servants of God, to our beloved son, Allwyn de Silva, priest of the Archdiocese of Bombay, and until now, Episcopal Vicar and parish priest of the parish of St. John the Baptist, elected auxiliary of the same Archdiocese, and at the same time, titular Bishop of Durin, greetings and an apostolic blessing. With our pastoral care that leads us to provide for the good of the universal flock of the faithful, we are fully confident in the divine mercy that always and everywhere manifests God's love for every single creature and for creation as a whole. At the same time, we want to offer every help possible to the sacred ministers who work in the church for the integral health of the faithful, so that they produce the best fruits in their work for the salvation of the souls and the consolation of the same faithful. Turning our eyes to the concrete needs of the community of Bombay, we willingly respond to the request recently addressed to us by the pastor of that archdiocese, our venerable brother, Oswald Cardinal Gracias, that we appoint a collaborator able to help him in the care and responsibility of the flock. Having this in mind, we thought of choosing you as auxiliary bishop. Gifted as you are with the human qualities and with other requisites that are needed for this task. Therefore, after hearing the favorable opinion of the Congregation for the Evangelization of Peoples, with our supreme authority and by virtue of the present letter, we appoint you Auxiliary Bishop of Bombay and at the same time nominate you Titular Bishop of Durin with all the rights and obligations inherent to this office. We allow you to be ordained outside the city of Rome by any Catholic bishop with due observance of the liturgical norms. Before that, according to the canonical laws, you will make the profession of faith and will take the oath of fidelity to us and to our successors. Dear son, we pray to the Lord that he should grant you the grace of attaining that high degree of humility that makes us just, enables us to love those whom Jesus loved and teach what Jesus taught. given in Rome at St. Peter's on the 20th of December of the year of the Lord 2017, fourth of our pontificate, Francis.
Thanks be to God, thanks be to God, thanks be to God. Thanks be to God, thanks be to God, thanks be to
Most Reverend Father, the Holy Catholic Church, our Mother, asks you to ordain this priest, Father Barthol Barretto, to the responsibility of the episcopate.
Do you have a mandate from the Holy See?
We have.
Then let it be read.
Franciscus Episcopus Servus Servorum Dei, Dilecto Filio Bartolomeo Barretto, Eclero Metropolitane Ecclesiae Bombayensis, Constituto Auxiliari Eiustem Sedis, Simulque Electo Episcopo Titulo Strongulensi, Salutem et Apostolicam Benedictionem. Quo plenius atque uberius pastorali Christi Fidelium Suorum cure posset providere, Nuper venerabilis frater noster Oswaldus Sancte Romanae Ecclesiae Cardinalis Gracias, Archiepiscopus Metropolita Bombayensis, ab hac apostolica sede petivit auxiliarem. Nos quidem solliciti de omnibus particularibus ecclesiis, uius pastoris preces cupientes audire, te dilecte filii, egregis dotibus ornatum, sacrarumque rerum loci, historieque peritum, idoneum putamus eius modi officio exequendo. Audita igitur sententia congregationis pro censium evangelizatione, summa nostra potestate te nominamus auxiliarem bombayensem, simulque renunciamus episcopum titulo strongulensem, cunctis cum juribus et obligationibus tali muneri et episcopali dignitati ad normam juris adnexis. Permittimus ut ordinationem a quo libet catholico episcopo extra urbem Romam accipias, liturgis servatis legibus, antea autem tum erit catholice fidei professionem facere, atque ius jurandum dare fidelitatis erga nos et nostros successores, secundum sacros canones. Fa denique, dilecte fili, fraterna conjunctus caritate cum sacro presule Bombayensi, creditum officium impleas totis viribus, sed maxime fisus Christo Domino, Magistro Divino, qui rediturus ad Patrem promisit, et ecce ego vobiscum sum omnibus diebus usque ad consummationem seculi. Adsit tibi benigna de celo precamur, Beata Virgo Maria, Augusta dilecte Indie Matre. Datum Romae apud Sanctum Petrum, die vicesimo mentis dicembris, anno Domini bismillesimo decimo sexto, pontificatus nostri quarto, Franciscus.
Francis Bishop, servant of the servants of God, to our beloved son Barthol Barretto, priest of the Metropolitan See of Bombay, nominated auxiliary of the same church, and at the same time bishop elect of Strongholy, greetings and apostolic blessing. Our venerable brother Oswald, Cardinal Gracias, Metropolitan Archbishop of Bombay, recently requested the appointment of an auxiliary to provide in a more fruitful way for the pastoral good of the faithful. Being entrusted with the care of all the local churches, and after considering this request made by this pastor, we decided to appoint you as the right person to this office, given your outstanding qualities and being well-versed in sacred matters and in the history of the local church. Therefore, after hearing the favorable opinion of the Congregation for the Evangelization of Peoples, with our supreme authority, we appoint you Auxiliary Bishop of Bombay, and at the same time nominate you Titular Bishop of Strongholy, with all the rights and obligations inherent by law to this episcopal dignity and to this office. We allow you to be ordained outside the city of Rome by any Catholic bishop with due observance of the liturgical norms. Before that, according to the canonical laws, you will make the profession of faith and will take the oath of fidelity to us and to our successors. Finally, dear son, perform this duty entrusted to you in brotherly communion with the Archbishop of Bombay, and do it with all your strength and with total trust in our Lord Jesus Christ, the Divine Master, who before he returned to his Father, promised that I am with you always to the end of time. Matthew 28:20. May the Blessed Virgin Mary, the loving mother of our beloved India, assist you from heaven. Given in Rome at St. Peter's on the 20th of December of the year of the Lord, 2017, fourth of our pontificate. Francis.
Thanks be to God. Thanks be to God.
Part of the rite is that the bull is shown to the Archbishop and to the consultors and to the congregation. This is the bull signed by the Holy Father. My dear bishops elect, Barthol Allwyn, my dear brother, archbishops, bishops, dear Monsignor from the Vatican, Nunciature, dearest fathers, my dear sisters, religious sisters, and brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ. Today is a day of great rejoicing in our Archdiocese of Bombay, a very historic day. For today, on the feast of St. Thomas Aquinas, the great doctor of the church, we are receiving a gift from God of two new auxiliary bishops in this archdiocese. How happy we are. What a joy it is to each one of us. In a special way for the parishioners of Thane and Borivali, and also for each one of us in this Archdiocese of Bombay and the Western region and the Church in India, well represented over here. While the parishes of Thane and Borivali rejoice because their pastors have been called by the Lord to a greater leadership role, all of us rejoice because we have new shepherds to assist in the leadership of the church, new leaders to guide us, new teachers to instruct us, holy men to take us to the Lord. Our Lord Jesus Christ called his 12 apostles, and after his ascension, to continue the work, to assist them, the apostles appointed bishops by the imposition of hands. And the same will be done this evening. Allwyn de Silva and Barthol Barretto, through the imposition of hands, following the ancient tradition from the very apostolic times, and saying the approved formula, will now join the ranks as shepherds of the church. Being a shepherd of the church is most challenging at any time, but especially in our times. Our chief shepherd, Pope Francis, has been insisting on the central role of the bishops and has consistently been encouraging and guiding our bishops in their role as leaders of the church. I know, Father Barthol, Father Allwyn, that in preparing for this episcopal consecration of yours, you have made a retreat. You have spoken to the Lord and perhaps have asked him, why did he choose you? And what mission does he call you to now? You surely have received many insights as you prayed, and the Lord will have spoken to you. Permit me to highlight a few points during this brief reflection, as we've heard the word of God and think about it. Feed my lamb, feed my sheep, become good shepherds. What does this mean to me, Father Allwyn? What does this mean to me, Father Barthol? Each one of us is unique, and we are called to be shepherds in our own unique style. Pope Francis has been insisting that shepherds must have the smell of the sheep. This smell you will have if you are connected to the sheep, approachable, welcoming, understanding. A leader can be with his people and yet not have the smell of the sheep, unless he opens his heart to them. It is not just a question of being physically present, but an attitude of the heart, receiving people, loving them, understanding them, sharing in their joys and sorrows. From today onwards, Barthol and Allwyn, yours is not just a 9-to-5 office or even a 9-to-9 office. You are called to be 24 hours at the service of your people, just as the Lord Jesus was always available to his people. We've just completed the year of mercy. On the conclusion of the year of mercy, the Jubilee year, Pope Francis issued an apostolic letter, Misericordia et Misera, where he reminded us that the year of mercy has passed, but mercy and compassion cannot be forgotten. It is an essential element of Christ's teaching. We have to promote a culture of mercy, says the Pope. That is why in the Archdiocese of Bombay, in the coming year, we will have as our theme promoting the culture of mercy.
that every parish, every institution, every religious house, and every family becomes an oasis of mercy, reaching out to those on the periphery, welcoming all those in distress. This you are called to do, we are called to do, in a very special way. Strive that in the Archdiocese of Bombay, no one goes to bed hungry. No single child is deprived of education because of lack of means. Never forget, as Mother Teresa reminded us, that on the periphery are not only those in material poverty, but also those in spiritual, moral, and emotional poverty. This is how we bring Christ to them, and this is the call of the times to us. Again, in the Archdiocese of Bombay, we have a very well-trained laity, educated, enthusiastic, competent, vibrant, wanting to work for the Church. The Second Vatican Council has reminded us how vital the laity are for the life and the work of the Church, and what their role and vocation is. The Archdiocese of Bombay has had the privilege of having a system of small Christian communities. With this and with other associations and other groups, can be used effectively to promote the apostolate of the laity. It is only with the laity with us that the Church can be fully alive. Hence, educate them, confirm them, encourage them, work with them, and teach them to work with others. Mumbai is a cosmopolitan city, perhaps the most cosmopolitan city in India, and striving to be first even in Asia. This is our richness. Not all of us are for the same culture, language, or religion. Hence, dialogue is important. Dialogue with people of other cultures, dialogue with people of other religions, dialogue with people of other languages. Hasn't Pope Francis been repeatedly insisting on a welcoming attitude to migrants? They are ours, part of the family. You and I must foster this pastoral approach. More and more we realize that we are in need of others if we are to make God's kingdom present in our place and in our time. We have a lot of social work in Archdiocese, but we cannot transform all of society by ourselves. We must work hand in hand with government, collaborate with them, other NGOs, network adequately. A dialogue with government, therefore, is important and essential for our work. I want to stress the necessity of dialogue with other religions. As Pope Francis has given us a lead, as did St. John Paul II years ago, and Pope Benedict. We, as Christians, as Catholics, can be catalysts that can promote harmony and integration among people of diverse cultures, languages, and religions. As we continue our reflections, I'm reminded of the wording of today's second reading, which said so clearly, "The Lord has chosen you not for your strengths, but for your weaknesses. And in your weakness, He will show His strength. And only with Him and through Him can we fulfill the task given to us." Both brothers and sisters, Father Allwyn and Father Barthol, bring a great contribution to the leadership of this archdiocese. Both have been parish priests, successful,
loved by people. Both have a special love for their people. Both have been associated with the central office of the Archdiocese, the Archbishop and his Curia. Both have been associated with the seminary. And yet both are also different and complement each other so much. One has done much in planning for pastoral work. The other has spent more time in pastoral work. One has had much exposure in India and outside. The other has had deep exposure in the Archdiocese. What richness in the Archdiocese to have these two men with us at the helm. Now we have the two of you, Allwyn and Barthol. I very warmly and heartily welcome you to the leadership of this Archdiocese of Bombay, and a very warm embrace to you from me, from Bishop Savio, Bishop John, our old Emeriti Archbishops, Bishops, and the other bishops here present. How excited I was the moment Pope Francis told me that he was giving me two auxiliary bishops. I thanked him. But above all, I thank the Lord for giving this gift to the Archdiocese of Bombay of two precious, valuable, dedicated priests to be our leaders. The vast crowd here assures you, Father Allwyn, Father Barthol, of our prayers. I pray that the Archdiocese of Bombay will, through your efforts, through your sweat and tears, receive many, many blessings. May Mary, our Mother, continuously intercede for us, for each one of us, especially the two of you. May this Archdiocese of Bombay, dedicated to her as its patroness, continue to make God's kingdom present. And may each one of us, bishops, priests, clergy and religious and laity, spend ourselves for his glory, the service of the people and the spread of God's kingdom. God bless each one of you.
The bishops-elect will now publicly affirm their obedience to the Holy Father, their fidelity to the gospel of Christ and the teachings of the Church, and their willingness to shepherd the faithful entrusted to their care.
The ancient rule of the Holy Fathers ordains that a bishop-elect is to be questioned in the presence of the people on his resolve to uphold the faith and to discharge his duty. And so, my dear brothers, Father Allwyn, Father Barthol, you resolve by the grace of the Holy Spirit to discharge until death the office entrusted to us by the apostles, which we are about to pass on to you by the laying on of hands?
I do.
Do you resolve to preach the gospel of Christ with constancy and fidelity?
I do.
Do you resolve to guard the deposit of faith, entire and incorrupt, as handed down by the apostles, preserved in the church everywhere and at all times?
I do.
Do you resolve to build up the body of Christ, his church, and to remain in the unity of that body, together with the order of bishops, under the authority of the successor of Saint Peter the Apostle?
I do.
you resolve to render obedience faithfully to the successor of the blessed Apostle Peter?
I do.
Do you resolve to guide the holy people of God in the way of salvation as devoted fathers and to sustain them with the help of your fellow ministers, priests, and deacons?
I do.
Do you resolve for the sake of the Lord's name to be welcoming and merciful to the poor, to strangers, and to all who are in need?
I do.
Do you resolve as good shepherds to seek out the sheep who stray and to gather them into the Lord's fold?
I do.
Do you resolve to pray without ceasing to Almighty God for our holy people and to carry out the office of high priest without reproach?
I do, with the help of God.
May God, who has begun the good work in you, bring it to fulfillment.
Having accepted their responsibilities as bishops, they seek God's blessings on them and their work. As they now prostrate themselves, the litany of the saints is sung by the choir, and we will join in the responses. The litany is a prayer to the triune God, which also includes invocations for the intercession of the Blessed Virgin Mary, the angels, and all the martyrs and saints upon whom Christianity was founded, and those recognized as saints through the subsequent history of the Church. Following the invocation of the saints, the litany concludes with a series of supplications to God to hear the prayer of the worshipers. Kindly stand.
Dearly beloved, let us pray that the kindness of Almighty God in providing for the welfare of the Church will grant an abundance of His grace for these chosen ones, Allwyn and Barthol.
Lawrence, pray for us. Perpetua and Saint Felicity.
Pray for us.
Saint Agnes.
Pray for us.
Saint Basil.
Pray for us.
Saint Gregory.
Pray for us.
Saint Augustine. Athanasius,
pray for us.
Saint Martin,
pray for us.
Saint Benedict,
pray for us.
Saint Francis and Saint Dominic,
pray for us.
Saint Francis, Savior,
pray for us.
Saint Gonzalo Garcia,
pray for us.
Saint John Vianney,
pray for us.
Saint Pius,
pray for us.
Saint Clare and Saint Catherine,
Lord, hear our prayer.
Christ, your
graciously hear our petitions, O Lord, and pour out on these, your servants, the power of your blessing, flowing from the horn of priestly grace. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The bishop-elect will now kneel before His Eminence Oswald Cardinal Gracias, His Grace Archbishop Vincent Conceição, His Lordship Bishop Bosco Pena, and the concelebrating bishops, who will lay hands upon their heads in silence. The laying on of hands symbolizes the bestowal of blessings, authority, and distinctiveness. It is a symbolic act designed to represent God Himself, setting a person apart for a holy use, whether for service, healing, protection, and guidance or blessing. We will now have the prayer of consecration as the book of the Gospels is opened and placed on the heads of the bishops elect. The prayer invokes the Spirit of God given to Jesus, who gave it to the apostles who founded the church wherever they were able to for God's greater glory. It is a prayer that seeks blessings on the bishops elect to be shepherds of God's flock as they minister to him night and day, presenting their lives as a fragrant offering to God.
God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, Father of mercies and God of all consolation, who dwell on high and look on the lowly, who know all things before they come to be, and who lay down observances in your church through the word of your grace, who from the beginning foreordained the nation of the just, born of Abraham, who established rulers and priests, did not leave any sanctuary without ministers, and who from the foundation of the world was pleased to be glorified in those you have chosen. Pour out now upon these chosen ones the power which is from you, the governing spirit which you gave to your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, the spirit whom he bestowed upon the holy apostles who established the church in each place as your sanctuary for the glory and unceasing praise of your name. Grant, O Father, knower of all hearts, that these your servants, whom you have chosen for the office of bishop, may shepherd your holy flock. Serving you night and day, may they fulfill before you without reproach the ministry of the high priesthood, that always gaining your favor, they may offer up the gifts of your holy church. Grant that by the power of the spirit of the high priesthood, they may have the power to forgive sins according to your command, assign offices according to your decree, and lose every bond according to the power given by you to the apostles. May they please you by their meekness and purity of heart, presenting a fragrant offering to you through your Son Jesus Christ, through whom glory and power and honor are yours, with the Holy Spirit, in the Holy Church, now and forever and ever.
The bishops elect are now anointed with the sacred chrism. Oil is a symbol of anointing by the Holy Spirit. In the Old Testament, the high priest was consecrated by anointing with oil and clothing with vestments. In the New Testament, it was transposed to anointing with the Holy Spirit and the ornament of virtues. The hands of the bishop-elect are not anointed since they have already been anointed at their presbyteral ordination.
May God, who has made you a sharer in the high priesthood of Christ, himself pour out upon you the oil of mystical anointing and make you fruitful with an abundance of spiritual blessings. May God, who has made you a sharer in the high priesthood of Christ, himself pour out upon you the oil of mystical anointing and make you fruitful with an abundance of spiritual blessings.
The book of the Gospels is now presented to the newly ordained bishops, reminding them of their important duty of preaching the gospel. The bishops build up the people with the word of God.
Receive the gospel and preach the word of God with all patience and sound teaching. Receive the gospel and preach the word of God with all patience and sound teaching.
The new bishops are now invested with the ring, which signifies the bishop's fidelity to and the nuptial bond with the church, his spouse. The mitre to be worn at important liturgical ceremonies and the pastoral staff or crozier, which symbolizes the shepherd's staff and the bishop's role as the shepherd of the flock entrusted to his care.
Receive this ring, the seal of fidelity, adorned with undefiled faith, preserve unblemished the bride of God, the Holy Church. Receive the mitre. May the splendor of holiness shine forth in you, that when the chief shepherd appears, you may deserve to receive from him an unfading crown of glory. Receive this ring, the seal of fidelity, adorned with undefiled faith. Preserve unblemished the bride of God, the Holy Church. Receive the mitre. May the splendor of holiness shine forth in you, that when the chief shepherd appears, you may deserve to receive from him an unfading crown of glory. Receive the crozier, the sign of your pastoral office. Keep watch over the whole flock in which the Holy Spirit has placed you as bishop to govern the Church of God. Receive the crozier, the sign of your pastoral office. Keep watch over the whole flock in which the Holy Spirit has placed you as bishop to govern the Church of God.
The new bishops will now be led to their places in the sanctuary and will then receive the kiss of peace from His Eminence Cardinal Oswald Gracias and the other concelebrating bishops, signifying their reception into the Episcopal College and the collegiality of bishops.
Congregation can sit.
Please be seated. Kindly stand for the creed.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, the only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit, and born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He went down to the dead. The third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, forgiveness of sins, resurrection of the body, life everlasting. Amen.
Please be seated for the offertory.
Our body is able.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that your sacrifice and mine may be acceptable to God, our Father in heaven. May this oblation, O Lord, which we have presented for your church and for these your servants newly ordained as bishops, become an offering acceptable to you, and for the good of the flock, may those you've raised up among your people to be high priests be endowed by your gift with apostolic virtues through Christ our Lord. Amen.